Hello students, standard 8, comparing quantities. We are almost at the end of the chapter doing the exercise 8.3. In first question we did some examples and others are given for the homework. Let's start with the question number 2. Kamala borrowed rupees 26,400 from a bank to buy a scooter at a rate of 15% PA. PA means per annum, means annually, compounded yearly. What amount will she pay at the end of 2 years and 4 months to clear the loan? So here you can see that the time limit, time period is 2 years and 4 months. So first what will we do? We will find out the amount of compound interest for 2 years, and that amount will be principal for the another 4 months, and for 4 months you have to find the simple interest and amount, and then we will add them to get the final answer. So here first we will find amount of compound interest for 2 years, and then for that amount we will find simple interest for 4 months, means 4 by 12 years. So now for 2 years we know that principal is 26,400, rate of interest is 15%, and n will be first, we have to take only 2 years. So now A is equal to P into bracket 1 plus R upon 100 raised to n, that is equal to 26,400 into bracket 1 plus 15 upon 100 raised to 2, and that will be 26,400 into, if you take LCM and add that 115 upon 100 multiply by 115 upon 100. So now we have to do the cancellations, and then if possible the again cancellation here. You can see that it is 5, so 25 is 100, 5 2 is 10, and 5 3 is 15. Here also we can do the same thing, 23 5 is 4 5 is equal to 264 multiplied by 23 multiplied by 23 divided by 4. So here 4 6 are 24 and 4 6 are 24. So now we have to multiply them, 66 multiplied by 23 multiplied by 23, and that will be I did it in the rough. So it will be 34914. So that is the amount for the 2 years. Now, for 4 by 12 years, P will be 34914, R will be same 15%, and N will be 4 by 2 years. 4 months, but months must be converted into the years. Therefore, simple interest is equal to PRN upon 100. That is 34914 multiply by 15 multiply by 4 by 12 into 100. And then that we have to do the required cancellations. Here we will multiply them. 5 4s are 20. 7 1 7 4 5 7 0 upon 100. So rupees 1745.7, or you can write down 0.70. Now that interest also should be added in this for the total amount that she had to pay after that. So total amount is equal to rupees that we get here, 34914, plus the simple interest 1745.70, and that will give you the answer. That will be 36659.70. So that amount she has to pay after the 2 years and 4 months so that she can clear the loan. Now question number 3, you will do it for homework. Now question number 4, I borrowed rupees 12,000 from Jamshed at 6% per annum simple interest for 2 years. Had I borrowed this sum at 6% per annum annual compounded interest, what extra amount would I have to pay? So here I borrowed at simple interest, but if I had borrowed compound interest, then what extra amount I have to pay? It means that simply here we have to find the simple interest, compound interest, and the difference between them, so that whatever extra amount we have to find. So first we will find the simple interest. So now first simple interest. So for simple interest, P is equal to rupees how much? 12,000. Rate of interest is 6% per annum, and time N is 2 years. So now first we will find the simple interest. So now simple interest is equal to PRN upon 100. That will be 12,000 multiplied by 6 multiply by 2 divide by 100. So here zeros cancel. 6 to the 12, 12, 12 is 144. So rupees 1440. That is the simple interest that I has to pay to Jamset. Now, if I had borrowed it at annual compound interest. So now, second part, compound interest. Annually. So here also P is same, rupees 12,000. R is also 6% and N is also 2 years. So now first we have to find amount A is equal to P into bracket 1 plus R upon 100 power N. So that is 12,000 into bracket 1 plus 6 upon 100 raised to 2. So that is equal to 12,000 multiplied by 106 upon 100 multiplied by, you know that if you take LCM 100, 100 plus 100 plus 6, 106 upon 100 and 2 power, so we have to write down multiplied by 2. So now 120, 120 and another 10 is cancelled. So now we will multiply and then put two decimal, only one decimal we will cut from the answer. So now 106 multiplied by 106 multiplied by 12. So 106 multiplied by 106 first we will do. It is 11,236 and multiply by 12. Divide by 10 and that is 1,3483.20. One decimal, but we write down as paise, so 20. So now compound interest is equal to A minus P. That is 1,3483.20 minus 12,000. So that will be rupees 1,483.20. So now we have to find the difference. So now extra amount to pay is equal to compound interest minus simple interest. Compound interest is rupees 1,483.20 minus simple interest is 1,440.00. So 0.20, okay, we will do it here. 1,483.20 minus 1,440. 3 minus 0, 3, 8 minus 4, 4, and that's a 43. So rupees 43.20 that extra amount I has to pay for the compound interest. So here we can see that if we borrow money, then if the amount is same, rate of interest is also same, number of years is also same, then compound interest will take your more money. You can see here that if we borrowed from the simple interest, then the amount will be small, but the compound interest will be more than the simple interest. So by this way you can find out the extra amount. So we are going to finish today's session, and it will be followed by the PDF file. And as usual, if any problem, you can write down in the comment section. Thank you very much.